So, it's been a very long time since I posted anything, since I filmed a video, because work has been crazy, I never get any time to myself anymore. It's madness, but we're going to start the green page, and I had no ideas where I wanted to go with this, so I just decided we'll do abstract. We will use up some washi tape and we'll just see where it takes us. Play. So I've pulled out all my green washi tapes. I'm going to use a little bit of every one of them because, as most artists, mixed media artists, I have way too much washi tape. So, I think I'm going to use a lot of white space on this page, maybe. We'll see. Try and stick to sort of the middle here. Build. Just try not to think about this too much. Pop it down where I feel like. Let's see. Oh, there it is. I couldn't find the end then. So, while I was gessoing this page, the cat decided to come in and try and walk on it. So I had to chase him and make sure he wasn't spreading gesso everywhere. Of course he wouldn't let me touch him. Some of this is not very sticky, as we know, washi tape. Sometimes that's not very sticky at all, but that's fine. I am going to be layering. And I have this, which is not washi tape, but it's a really shiny tape. So we're going to go over with some clear gesso. And that's not going to rip, so scissors. Which I need to open. My friend sent me this happy mail. I've never used it. Mostly because it's green and I don't really use green, so this project is perfect. So this is a perfect project for when you don't use a colour normally. Ooh, it's actually like a paper. I thought it was going to be a shiny tape that you just unroll and stick down, but I think you peel it off. Yeah, ooh. So it's shiny on the bottom, the top is like a paper. Ooh, nice. Okay, so yeah, I'm going to use this more often then. That means gesso will go over it quite nicely. So even though it's green, I can change colour easily. Lovely. I more of that, I think. I really like that. There's not a lot on the roll. That's okay. We can use it all up on here. That's fine. What's the point in having it if you don't use it? Now then, do I go with clear gesso or white, or do I put clear then white? Yes, I think I'm going to clear gesso it, and then I'm going to go in some areas and just add a little bit of white. So yeah, just so. Clear gesso is going to make sure that that stays down. I would use matte medium. Oh, I could have used matte medium. No, but I want to make sure that it's all sealed and primed for painting. Whereas matte medium resists paint sometimes, so that's why I'm using the clear gesso, because that means that we get both, we get the ceiling and we can paint over it. Okay, so we dry that. Yes, let's dry that. And then add some gesso. So I will be right back. Okay, so that's pretty much dry. And then we will grab the white gesso. Go over the background a little bit more. Upside down a little more. Okay. So now I'm going to dry that off again, and then we'll come in with some sprays. Yeah, some sprays. Okay, so I have two sprays and two stencils, so these may not spray, which is fine. We'll see. See what happens. You know what it's like using spray bottles, so I'm going to pop that there, and I've got some paper. Overspray. I don't mind about this bit, it's fine. So let's go with the Lindy's first, because hopefully this one should spray and is better. Bells of Ireland Green. I haven't used these for ages. Stick some weight on it really, but that's... Okay. A failed gel print experiment. Okay, so that's worked out okay. Of course, I'm covered in paint. Gesso is not quite dry. Never mind. Let's do the same. Oh, let's dry it. Okay. I'm spraying downwards to try and avoid it from going under the stencil as much as possible. Okay, I think I might have just smudged that then. Oops. Okay, that's fine. Okay, now let's try this stencil. And again, bring in the paper. I'm not sure this one was going to spray. No. Nope, definitely not gonna spray. Okay. Shoo. Okay. So what we will do then is grab the thing out and stir this up. It's not very dark actually, is it? This was a homemade one. No, I don't think that's gonna work. So let me go into my resin stash. Oops. Alcoholic. give this a go. This is what we've got. I do have a water bottle. I'm not sure if this is going to work at all with alcohol. Oh, you know what will work? Alcohol spray. Dry that a little bit, just a little bit more dripping is fine. Let's go this side. Okay. Oh, that's not the lid for that. That's the lid for that. So where's the lid for that? It's there. Okay, so now I think we need some green splashes. So let's see what we've got in here. Now I'll kind of ink away. So I've got my gouaches, go for a deep clean. Let's let that soak in some water and spray something like this. So a window if I can. Okay, so try that. Do I dry it? Do I spread it? Now I need a brush. Where's my little fun brush? Not sure, we'll use the big one then. So we're going in with this dark green. Okay. Okay. Stop there. Right. And again, I think we will dry that. Just put this away. No, have it. Thought I put it away properly, but I haven't. Okay, so I'm just going to pop some black paint out on here. Not a lot. Let me dry that off. And use up that. I'll be right back. Okay, so I'm going to use some Amata stickers. Couldn't find a quote that I liked, but this will work quite nicely, I think. You see what I see? Just gonna burnish it a little bit so that it isn't so obvious that it's a sticker. It does take a little bit of that shininess away. Okay. And then get this one. Here we go. Creative mess. There's a perfect space for that just then. Or should I put explore? I think I'm going to put explore. I think that is that. Now, have I been dating these? Yes, I have. So I'm going to date that today's date, which is the 4th, yes. 4th of the 10th. There we go. A simple creative page with lots of white space and the colour green. So, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed that. This will be in a playlist with the rest of the colour series. So, I hope you enjoy that. And I hope to see